There's a set of non-mathematical tools that form the logical backbone of a project. And you can see here process map, cause and effect matrix, failure modes and effects analysis, and control plan. And most of what you're going to do early on flows in through the FMEA, and most of the actions you're going to take in the improve phase flow out of the FMEA. So let's just take a look at how some of this works. This is a process map, and in it we're trying to collect the variables that influence the outcomes that are important to us. Well, not all variables are of equal importance. When you go to the cause and effect matrix, you will find that the variables from the process map have been automatically carried forward, and the CTQs will have been placed across here. What remains for you to do then is to give weights and fill in the matrix and click calculate. Then you'll say, well, okay, let's not pay attention to the weak variables. Let's disable those. And then let's go to the FMEA. Now, you'll notice that I've got cook skill, recipe, baking time indicated as strong variables in baking bread. And lo and behold, here are those same five variables popping up over here. Basically one page for each. Let's see, I've got that slid over. Let me bring this back so that you can see that you've got failure modes and severity and occurrence and detection. And then when you get over here, you have some kind of a suggested action and this little carry forward symbol. Well, what we did in the C&E matrix is we decided to not carry forward a bunch of weak variables, and in the FMEA we will decide that there are some variables that don't have enough strength that they merit an action plan. The strong variables will indicate here, and those will carry forward into the action plan. Okay, and there we'll detail what we're going to do with them and who's assigned. And lo and behold, here are the carry forward arrows that will take the most important ones out of the FMEA over into the control plan. This is where you record the results of the improvements that you're making. This is where you plan and organize all of the other things that you're going to do. So when we get down to the control plan down here, we have weeded the number of variables that we need an overt control plan on down to just a few, and there we'll have an error indicator and our response plan. So that's how the backbone tools fit together in a Six Sigma project.